Mining occurs throughout Australia, but any individual mine is really small, and so the total direct impacts on Australia, you know, on less than 1% of the country, so relatively small. But it's not the impacts of an individual mine that's really the issue, it's the cumulative impacts of a number of mines, particularly prospective regions where there are a lot of mines. And often it's not the direct impacts of the mine sites themselves, but it's the indirect impacts, all the infrastructure that's needed to service the mines. So all the roads, the pipelines, the towns, the ports, it's that infrastructure that often has the greater impact on biodiversity than the mines themselves. So the best way of managing these cumulative and indirect impacts of mining on these highly prospective mineral regions is through a process called strategic regional assessment, where before all the mines come in, there's a general assessment of the biodiversity assets of the whole region, and then this can form an overall planning framework for new and prospective mines. And this has the advantage of protecting biodiversity in the region, but also providing clear goalposts for the mineral industry so they can plan their operations. So a good example of the strategic regional assessment process is with the Great Barrier Reef. Now, there's no mining on the Great Barrier Reef, but there's a range of indirect impacts of activities on the land in terms of dredging, increased shipping traffic, coastal development, and the strategic regional planning process can identify all the important biodiversity assets of the reef and allow the planning of those things to take place in the most environmentally sensitive way. Mining companies now have a requirement to rehabilitate their mine sites, and there's been a strong move away from just greening up the area affected to creating sustainable ecosystems that integrate with the surrounding landscape. One of the great challenges with mine site rehabilitation is not just doing the rehabilitating, but measuring its success. So how can we know when a mine site has been successfully rehabilitated? And in order to do that, we need to go beyond just measuring the plants, which are the things that we actually put there in the first place, but measuring the fauna associated with the plants and measuring some ecological processes that give us confidence that the ecosystem is in fact a healthy and properly functioning one. And one of the common ways of doing that is to use bioindicators, so plant or animal species that are very important in the ecosystem and give us a general indication of ecosystem health. And the most widely used animal bioindicator in the mining industry is ants. So ants are arguably the most important faunal group in the Australian environment in terms of their sheer numbers, their role in turning over nutrients and energy flow, their role in creating soils, and their role in protecting and promoting plant performance. And so most of the major mine sites throughout Australia have had ant monitoring programs to measure the success of their rehabilitation efforts. And so the way it works using ants as bioindicators is that we monitor over time changes in ant species at the rehabilitating sites and compare them to what we call benchmark or reference sites, which are underserved sites in the region, and they're the goalposts that we want to get to. And as ant species composition and richness converges on that in the reference sites, then we can have some sort of confidence that rehabilitation is occurring successfully. Sometimes mining can have unavoidable impacts on biodiversity, but one way of managing this is through what we call offset programs, where the impacts of biodiversity at, say, the mine site itself is compensated by broader conservation programs elsewhere in the region. And a really good example is the arid recovery project as part of the Olympic Dam mine in South Australia, where the impacts of the mine itself are being compensated and arguably more than compensated for by this fabulous conservation program involving the reintroduction of all these small mammal species that have become extinct over the last century in South Australia. And so we're talking about iconic species like bilbies and numbats and bettongs and stick nest rats, and so a wide range of species that used to occur right across arid Australia but now are extinct throughout most of their range. And so a big feature of the arid recovery project is the building of these very, very large predator-proof exclosures where introduce predators like cats and foxes and other nasty introductions like rabbits have been removed, and all these species have been introduced and are now just thriving. And so that's really a fabulous conservation outcome, not just for the region, but for the whole nation. The mining industry has had a pretty poor history of environmental management in the past, but things have changed now with appropriate regulation. And so with strategic environmental assessments, with appropriate offset programs, all the wealth that mines create, there's a real opportunity for mining to have a net positive outcome for biodiversity in the regions in which they operate.